The National Science Day of 2020 is being held at a time when science in India is going through a very critical phase. We are seeing a situation where unscientific ideas, superstitions are being propagated by the people who wield power. We are in a situation where over a long period of time, the education system has not given people a scientific bent of mind, as a result of which many people who are educated in science, who are even scientists, they also harbor many types of unscientific beliefs and superstition. The common people who are deprived of being educated in a scientific way, they naturally have a natural tendency to believe and not to question. And utilizing this situation, various shades of unscientific beliefs are being propagated and people are being swayed by that. In this situation, it is a bounden duty of the scientific community of the country to take up the cause of science, especially in propagating scientific temper among the people. It is true that scientific temper is an integral part of our constitution. It is a constitutional duty of all Indian citizens to propagate and to have scientific temper. But it is this constitutional provision that has been routinely trampled underfoot by the people in power. And in this situation, the scientific community by themselves have to act. Otherwise, the future of science is bleak. In order to understand the reason why this is so, it is necessary to understand the history of science in India. It is true that India had a very rich tradition of science, especially from the time that is called the Siddhantic period, after the Vedic period, when the Buddhism and Jainism developed in India, and the total dominance of the Vedic period slowly was weakened. In this time, we see a large amount of development in science and technology. It is in India where medical science was developed in the hands of Charaka and Shushruta. It is in India that linguistics was developed in the hand of Panini. It is in India where the concept of zero and the place value system was developed, as a result of which there was a great development in mathematics, especially arithmetic, algebra, trigonometry, mensuration, in the hands of Aryabhatta, Brahmavira, Brahmagupta and Bhaskara. But this tradition did not continue for long, and we see like you had a dark middle age in Europe, we also had a dark middle age in India that started tentatively from the 9th century, and after the 11th century there was no science left in India. It was only in the 19th century when, through the efforts of people like Ram Mohan and Vidyasagar, that the ideas of European Renaissance was brought to India, and again we see a resurgence of science in India. It was in that situation where various types of unscientific beliefs, superstitions, customs, even the practice of burning sati, burning widows, and various unhealthy social practices were there. And these people launched an unwavering struggle against that, and through that a new type of society was established. In this, the major role was played by the scientists of that time, like Acharya Jagadish Chandra, Acharya Prafulla Chandra, Meghnath Saha, Satyendranath Bose, Ramanujan, Raman. We see a galaxy of scientists being produced at that time. But remember, that was a time when science was in a struggle with unscientific beliefs and superstitions. The scientists of that time did not take science as a career. They took science as a way of emancipation of our land through the use of science and technology, through freeing people's minds from the unscientific ideas and superstitions. But lately we find that that idea of science is no longer being propagated. Now, for most people in science, science has become nothing more than another career. In this situation, it is necessary then that the scientific community should act, realizing the danger that we are facing today, utilizing the cultural situation in the country. Now the forces of anti-science are raising their heads. And now, unless we launch a bitter struggle to defeat the forces of anti-science, science will not survive in this country. Thank you.